Everyone, it's Dr. Julie Two Moon. Welcome, welcome. This is my live broadcast today about the nature of time. So for those of you who aren't super familiar with me, I am, of course, a naturopathic doctor and an acupuncturist, and I have a program called From Surviving to Thriving, and it's all about ending our endless cycles of exhaustion and hormone imbalance and weight gain and frustration that happen so commonly for women after 40. So today, you know, I always hear people talk to me about, oh, I don't have time for that. I wish I just had more time. And I keep hearing this said, and it makes me keep thinking about the dynamic nature of time and some things that most people don't seem to have a connection with when it comes to the nature of this topic. So I thought I'd come today and talk to you a little bit about the nature of time, because I think many of you, like many other people, may be having a kind of skewed relationship with this particular subject, and changing your perspective may in fact do a whole lot to free up the ability to finally make some changes for yourself. So here's the deal. One of the secrets about time is that our perception and experience of time is actually directly related to how worn out we are. Now, if you are exhausted, everything gets slowed down. We're either running on absolute fatigue, or when we're exhausted, we're running on an exaggerated stress response. So you know that feeling where you're running on hyped up, super inflated energy. It's not real. It's often prompted by caffeine or sugar, or sometimes it's just prompted by, you know, kind of the adrenaline rush of trying to get stuff done, or the adrenaline rush of maybe having done some really intense exercise, or maybe just the adrenaline rush of being so super stressed. Either way, in that state, we feel that really sped up notion of things, but it doesn't actually give us more time. In fact, it tends to make us feel like we're running out of time. So here we are trying to be everything in our life to everyone that we can, and we are finding ourselves always pressed for more space to take care of the things we need to take care of, never even often finding the time just to take care of ourselves as well. Now, that hyperinflated, pushed forward, stressed out state is how many, many, many people are walking through the world, and they're sort of wide-eyed, frantically looking around and saying, there isn't enough, there isn't enough, there isn't enough. And I see people in that state all the time, and one of the things that must happen in that case is that the stress response has to be turned off and the energy systems have to be rebuilt. Because as long as you exist in that stressed out, hyperinflated state, you're going to alternate between feeling like everything is going really fast and you can't keep up, or you're so slowed down and barely movable. And so you just can't get anything done. And neither of those is an operating state that allows you to accomplish much of anything of value. And really, what's our time for if not to accomplish things of value? We're not here to exist in like obligation, operation states all day just to fulfill some meager, I don't know, place in the world. Very few people I know are doing like things of value. Like they're not getting to live out the dream of their spirit. And again, they'll often say, well, I don't have time for that because I have to do, and then they fill in the blank. So that's the first secret about time, is that it is a direct experience of how much energy is available in your system. So you may be saying, well, great, how do I get more energy? You get more energy by actually making targeted effects on diet, targeted effects on replacing your missing nutrients, targeted effects on carving out specific intent and shaping your mindset around nourishing yourself. And those may sound like, oh, that's just more about time. And it's not actually, because a mindset shift has to do with how we craft our belief systems, and our belief systems will in fact shape our reality. We don't talk about that enough in the world. The fact that Our belief about not having enough time is actually one of the things that creates less time for us, because we are existing in a paradigm by which time is something external to us. This is the second secret about time, by the way, that time is external to us and in reality, time is something that is found within us. We are the creators of time. But I find that when people are super exhausted and worn out and they're kind of funky, like the hormones are funky and their brain is funky, they can't perceive that reality. So their belief systems really continue to dictate the experience. But time is actually created by you. I know you may be thinking that can't possibly be, because that's not been my experience thus far. I feel like I am a victim to time. I am succumbing to time's influence, but it's not the case. You are actually the creator of time, and the way you perceive it and choose to experience it and the way you set your mindset and your belief systems will actually change how the experience happens. So, setting in motion belief systems that are organized around the fact that you are in fact the creator of time will do something magical to your life, and it will allow you the space to actually make the kind of changes you're looking for. So the first thing is that when you are feeling pressed for time, it is to stop and take some deep breaths and affirm to yourself, I am actually the creator of time. I am not going to succumb to this stressed out, hyperinflated place. I'm going to step into a relaxed manner and move forward based on that. This may sound super like, oh, that's too simple. It doesn't work. Absolutely does work. I've done it myself. I've watched other people do it. You can absolutely change your relationship with the experience by doing it that way. Now, when you do that, you're going to notice that everything slows down. Like suddenly it's like the field opens up. Like you're no longer in a crowd of 50,000 people trying to push their way through a narrow opening. All of a sudden, you're the only one on the road. And you get 10 times more done in half of the time. But in addition, your experience of it changes. This is one of the keys to opening up what you need to be able to dedicate the resources to finally solve the problem of the energy as well. I said, time is a factor of your energy and your belief systems. You can change your belief systems, but to power it, you're going to want to get into a state where you change your energy. And I see this in the people I work with, that you start to change the belief systems, which is always my first step. So whenever I start working with someone, we work on beliefs first, because your beliefs will shape your conscious reality by shifting your unconscious systems by which your reality is shaped. But then you have to find something to fuel it, because we can change our beliefs. And this is where I differ from a lot of the mindset people out there. They'll say, you can just change your beliefs and then everything else will follow. I disagree. Because you can change your beliefs, but if you don't have the energy to make intelligent action steps and change the reality of the physical self that you embody and the physical nature of you, then there's nothing to fuel the mindset change with. And this is massively huge, because this is what I see is happening all over the place. There's all these books, you know, How to Not Give a Bleep, and you know, all these things that people are following, and they're saying, oh, I'm changing my reality. And then they're kind of getting disappointed like 6 months, 8 months out. The Secret was a big one, because The Secret advocated you just have to change your beliefs. You know, you can sit on the couch and change your beliefs and suddenly you'll be thin and worth $10 million. And it doesn't work that way. So the belief change in relationship to time is essential, but you have to fuel it with something. And so you got to fill yourself up. So if you've been struggling with this, like if you're thinking, I already work 80 hours a week, and as it is, that's jam-packed, and there's no time left for me to take care of myself, and so I'm just doomed to suffer, you know, fat and over 40 and fatigued and frustrated forever, then right there I can tell you, you have a belief system that's dictating there's no time left. Secondly, you're fatigued and there's nothing to fuel it. And you need to change those two things and your relationship with time will change. And you know what that will look like? It'll look like you getting, like I said, twice the work done in half the time. So suddenly you're no longer burdened by 80 hours and you can start to, with authority, dictate the parameters of your working relationships, because you're filled up enough to be able to stand in that power and have people not try to back you down. Because that's another thing that keeps happening to us. People try to change the nature of relationships in their work or in their home life, and they don't have anything like to hold it up. Like the structure is just hyperinflated. It's like you're a balloon man, and as soon as someone like pushes you a little bit, it's like, oh, I'm going to fall over. And that's because there's nothing filling you up. And that's where most people are operating from. It's like this non-filled up hollow state. And so you don't have anything to work with to change the parameters of the relationship. And then you just keep kind of floundering in the same space, and it doesn't get you anywhere. So that space is where I know many of you are operating, because it's where tons of the women I speak to are operating from. And it's a flawed proposition, and it doesn't get better from here. I mean, it's not like, oh, it's only going to, in the next 5 years, it'll change. Likelihood is not, because I've checked in with people after I haven't spoken to them in 6 months or 2 years or 3 years. And 90% of the time, they're right where they were last time I spoke to them. Like, it didn't change at all. So it's time to change your relationship with time, so that you can change your relationship with your body, so you can change your relationship with your health, with your energy, so you can get your hormones balanced, so that you can step into your vitality, so that you can live your biggest dream, so that you can take part in the world the way that you're called to do, and step into your genius and actually craft something bigger than just making it from moment to moment, or barely making it from the beginning of the day to the end. That's not what you were made for. You are a divine miracle that is here for a reason. So let's get going on changing our relationship to time, so we can all craft something much bigger than what we're currently experiencing, and like have a physicality that represents that filled up state, that dynamic state of positive action, where you have something to fuel and structure your dreams off of. Because it's impossible to build a dream of massive proportions, or even just step into a life of vitality, if you're hollowed out and feeling like you're pressed for time every second of every day. So this is something that I can help you work on, for sure. But I really am here to give you some inspiration towards a place of clarity about your relationship with time and what it means, and why you may be feeling like there's never enough. So I wish you all a beautiful evening. Thank you for joining. I see those of you that are here. It's awesome to see you. Please reach out if you have questions. Please reach out. Comment below if you need some help, or if you just want to talk about your relationship with time. So have a beautiful evening. Many blessings.